Trump sending deadly convoy after what NK sick dictator was just spotted doing on 8,300 FT Sacred Mountain. Sometimes when people say we, they mean it symbolically, like when a couple says we're pregnant or when the CEO of a company says we have designed a better, fill in the blank, usually they aren't getting their hands dirty, and people know it. There's general, communal terminology, and then there's just trying to make yourself look better at someone else's expense. In the case of North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un, it seems to be a combination of the latter and good old-fashioned lying. Jong-un has decided to risk the lives of all 25 million North Korean souls under his care, as well as all the Americans he hopes to take out in the crossfire and pick a fight with the United States. Jong-un's insistence on continuing his nuclear missile tests, despite every diplomatic strategy to stop him, is a course of action that is likely to end in fatalities for the North Koreans. President Trump has tried time and again to reach out via diplomacy, but the petty dictator of North Korea continues his standoff, growing more and more aggressive, and his propaganda campaign has gotten more and ridiculous as time went on. Daily Mail reports of his most recent exploits and how transparent his lies are. Jong-un, who is not known for his athletic ability, apparently is claiming to have scaled an 8,300-foot mountain, all without so much as breaking a sweat. He is the chubby dictator who learned to drive at the age of 3 and once bragged of scoring 11 holes in one on his first round of golf. Now North Korean state media has made another dubious claim about Kim Jong-un's superhuman powers after insisting the overweight tyrant had climbed an 8,000-foot mountain. Pyongyang media said the 33-year-old had managed to scale Mount Baekdu, a sacred spot for North Koreans, after walking through thick snow to reach the summit. But pictures show Kim wandering around on the snow-capped mountain with hardly a bead of sweat and wearing spotless and shiny shoes. While all of this might seem a bit ridiculous to us, it all fits in perfectly with a carefully crafted image that Jong-un attempts to project to the rest of the world. One of the saddest things about Jong-un thinking that he can push this off on the world, I mean other than the possibility that he is planning to sacrifice millions of lives at the altar of his short man syndrome, is the fact that no one is able to talk to him and explain how crazy he seems. He obviously doesn't understand how sports work, and no one is willing to stand up and tell the emperor that in his own way, he has no clothes. Probably because his off with their heads kind of response to criticism has put a damper on the opinions of others. Defectors from North Korea's talk of growing up in a world where they believe that the ruling family can even hear the thoughts of those who would speak against the royal family. Here's more from our source about the details of not only Jong-un's impressive hike but his continued efforts to wipe the United States off the map. Rodong Sinmun reported how Kim's eyes reflected the strong beams of the gifted great person seeing in the majestic spirit of Mount Baekdu the appearance of a powerful socialist nation which dynamically advances full of vigor without vacillation at any raving dirty wind on the planet. Mount Baekdu has been decreed as the sacred birthplace of the secretive state's first dictator, Kim's grandfather. Pictures released by the regime show Kim in the snow on North Korea's border with China, which the regime rewrote history to claim was the birthplace of Kim Il-sung, the communist who ruled from after the Second World War until 1994. He was in fact born in the Soviet Union, but the mountain has long been integral to the country's identity. It is reputedly the birthplace of the earliest Korean leader ever recorded, Sangun, who according to legend founded the early kingdom of Gojoseon in 2333 BC. The mountain is believed to be the site of the deadliest volcano eruption in history, and there are fears it may erupt again as a result of North Korea's nuclear weapons testing. 1,000 years ago it exploded so violently that ash fell as far away as northern Japan. Last month Bruce Bennett, a senior defense analyst at the RAND Corporation, warned one of the nuclear weapon tests carried out by North Korea could have a catastrophic effect. North Korea, formerly called the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, DPRK, last week tested its most powerful intercontinental ballistic missile, saying the device could reach all of the United States. Two USB-1B heavy bombers joined large-scale combat drills over South Korea on Thursday amid warnings from North Korea that the exercises and U.S. threats have made the outbreak of war an established fact. The annual U.S.-South Korean Vigilante exercises feature 230 aircraft, including some of the most advanced U.S. stealth warplanes. North Korea's foreign ministry blamed the drills and confrontational warmongering by U.S. officials for making war inevitable. U.S. National Security Advisor H.R. McMaster said at the weekend the possibility of war was increasing every day. He said Trump was prepared to take action against North Korea but was working to convince China, Russia and others to do more to press Pyongyang to get it to give up its weapons programs. U.S. Republican Senator Lindsey Graham urged the Pentagon on Sunday to start moving U.S. military dependents out of South Korea, saying conflict with North Korea was getting close. The Pentagon said it has no intent to move out any dependents. Joseph Yun, the U.S. Special Representative for North Korea Policy, will travel to Japan and Thailand next week to meet government officials to discuss ways to strengthen the pressure campaign following the DPRK latest ballistic missile test, the State Department. The United States looks forward to continuing its partnership with both these nations so that the DPRK will return to credible talks on denuclearization, it added. But Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov says he believes the chances of dialogue to resolve the tensions over North Korea's nuclear weapons program are low. Lavrov was speaking Friday while attending an US ministerial summit in Vienna. He said the North Koreans have told us more than once that they'd need security guarantees, especially in the situation when Washington is trying to withdraw from the agreements on the Iranian nuclear program.